In 1970, Motown's very own Temptations released a song that would become one of their most intergenerational hits ever. Ball of Confusion is a song detailing many issues with America and the world at large around the time that the song was released. What made it stand the test of time is how relevant it is today and how even problems back then still affect us to this very day. The song was written by Norman Whitfield and Barrett Strong around a time when the civil rights movement was at its peak. By this time, many civil rights leaders such as Malcolm X and Martin Luther King Jr. were long since dead, having been targeted for their participation in the civil rights movement, and America was still dealing with a large issue that was the Vietnam War. The Temptations, before this point, was trying to maintain a clean image as they wanted to appeal to the largest audience possible by avoiding political topics. This would slowly change as Motown was starting to put Norman Whitfield in the position of producer for the Temptations. Norman Whitfield became the Temptations' sole producer and would collaborate with lyricist Barrett Strong on a number of songs. Norman would be inspired to experiment with new sounds at this time, and the first song that really grasped the audience's attention for this new sound was Cloud Nine, which was released after Puzzle People and was their big hit, and it even won a Grammy. However, Motown still wanted the Temptations to stay away from the political ideas to maintain an image of peace and love. So this would oftentimes lead to many songs that would be given to the Temptations being given to other artists. The main example of this is the song War, which was originally performed by the Temptations, but was given to Edwin Starr to mass acclaim and would outshine any other recording of the song. However, this wouldn't last too much longer as the Temps were eager to make a statement and were eager to really express how they really felt. And by 1969, the Temps were now fully invested in the Flower Power movement and were all about peace and love. And they felt that this was a right time to get involved politically, but also share the message of peace and love. 1969 was the real first time that the Temptations really made a political statement in a song. The album Puzzle People featured a few songs that were very aggressive in political nature. Slave is a song written as from the perspective of a slave worker, likely of the, since they're black singers, this was written from the perspective of slave workers in America, and really establishes how they feel like in their modern America. Another song that stands out is Message from a Black Man, which was the big message song from the album, and it establishes their stance and how they feel in the words, "No matter how hard you try, you can't stop me now." The Temps would build off this momentum on their following record, Cloud Nine, and Psychedelic Shack later. Psychedelic Shack was an album that was more aimed at maintaining the idea of peace and love, with many songs such as Psychedelic Shack and Friendship Train, which would mainly focus on spreading love and peace and avoiding war and anger altogether. It is a very bright album compared to stuff before and after. However, in 1970, the attitude would change completely when the song Ball of Confusion was released. The song itself features many lines that are very important in its storytelling, and it's very important in many different ways. The song opens with the line,
"People moving out, people moving in, why? Because of the color of the skin. Run, 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 but you sure can't hide."
Which makes a statement about racial division at the time. Followed is,
"An eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth, vote for me and I'll set you free. Rap on, brother, rap on."
Which is likely a commentary on how politicians at the time would come in office and not really do anything about any of the issues in America, which would continue to perpetuate many problems that bothered the regular man of America. They would make promises and abandon them in favor of corruption and would focus solely on their own gain rather than the people. The next line is spoken by Dennis, and it goes like this.
Well, the only person talking about love, thine brother, is the preacher. And it seems nobody's interested in learning but the teacher.
This is one of my many favorite lines from the song, as it points out the fact that America is not only divided by pure hate, with no middle ground in any sight, but is also unwilling to hear each other out and is solely focused on a war against each other. And that's very important for the time, as the Civil Rights Movement was a very big divisional moment for a lot of Americans, because a lot of Americans believed in the freedom of black people. But a lot of Americans wanted to maintain that there was no issue with what was happening. And this also bled into a lot of other political issues at the time, such as Vietnam. There was a lot of debate on whether we should be there or not, and a lot of Americans took the stance of we shouldn't, and a lot took the stance that we should not, or that we should. And those are the two real big moments that are really highlighted on the song, and it continues on throughout the rest. The next verse features a line by Paul Williams stating,
"The sale of pills are at an all-time high. Young folks walking around with their heads in the sky. Sin is aflame in the summertime.
And all the beat goes on."
Which points out the drug culture at the time of young Americans being high on weed, LSD, and a lot of urban Americans being high on certain drugs that, you know, like opioids and things like that, prescription drugs, and they were in a mass use around this time as people were dealing with the pain of everything around them. Also, the drug culture was usually associated with young kids and the hippie movement as being chalked up to young kids high on weed and such and such. Dennis later sings a line about
air pollution, revolution, gun control, the sound of soul, shooting rockets to the moon, kids growing up too soon, politicians say more taxes will solve everything.
With Melvin replying,
and the band played on.
This line is important to the message, as it's almost a self-reflection of who the Temptations actually used to be. It is a calling out of the fact that while the world burns and everything else is going wrong, people in the higher positions of society, such as themselves and, you know, other musicians, look on and continue to do their thing as if nothing's happening. And I always find that to be one of the most important lines that is repeated throughout the song, is the band played on, as it's true. A lot of Americans were unwilling to speak out about what they felt passionate about, and even they were told not to speak out of what they were really passionate about. Eddie sings the next verse, and it goes like this.
Fear in the air, tension everywhere, unemployment rising fast, the Beatles new records of gas.
With Dennis adding,
and the only safe place to live is on an Indian reservation.
Now, this line in the song is my favorite of the whole song, as for me, an indigenous person who actually does live on a reservation, I can actually understand what he's saying. At first, it did not make sense to me. As someone who is not a fan of living on the reservation, I didn't understand this. But it makes sense when you really look into it, because what he's saying is, with the state of America and the state of hate and how everyone is divided, that and with the threat of political corruption amongst those that are voted in to office, the only real safe place to live on is a reservation, as reservations are tribal owned land that are essentially self-governed. They're almost their own country, essentially. And I understand that perspective of, I'd rather live somewhere where at least like-minded people are running their own government, compared to living under a government that doesn't have my ideals in mind. So that line to me spoke a lot and really says a lot about the time and what people were really thinking. I always felt Norman Whitfield and Barrett Strong were geniuses in writing this specific line. Following that is a line listing off many other major issues that is sung by Dennis, and it goes,
Eve of destruction, tax deduction,
city inspectors, bill collectors,
hard clothing demand, population out of hand,
suicide, too many bills, hippies moving to the hill, people all over the world are shouting in the war.
And the band played on.
We're just stating that people are killing themselves and disconnecting themselves from the society as the pressure of maybe going to Vietnam or the pressure of not being able to pay your bills or many other things like that. You know, for a lot of Black Americans, you know, the pressure of not being able to feel home in your own country, it really got to a lot of people. And America at large was in a lot of pain. And, you know, like he says, the hippie movement would, you know, some people would outright disconnect themselves from society and live on their own, because that would be better than living under the government that there was. And people would kill themselves, you know. So that line also really spoke out to me. But we'll keep going. The song ends with the chorus that has been repeated throughout the song, as we already have heard. And one of my favorite parts is the last lines of the song is that's what the world is today. And that to me is probably the most important part of the song, is that's what the world is today. Because as we go into why this song is important to today, it really is true that that's what the world is. And it really goes to show that the guys who worked on this song and putting it together and writing it really took a lot of effort into writing this song to be not so much just about their time, but could be applied to any point in history, in my opinion. So, well, let's get into why this song is important to today. Now, this song has only become more relevant in the modern day, as a lot of the issues still persist as we live in today. With COVID pushing everyone inside and the political climate being just as unstable as it was back then, it's essentially just a different face for a similar issue. The issues that America faced, you know, 30, 40 years ago, 50 years ago, still persist today. It's just different people perpetuating it. You know, we still see America divided into two sides, with the right and the left, and, you know, a lot of simple political arguments about things like gay rights and so on and so forth. You know, Black Lives Matter being a major topic of today. And I won't get into my own political ideals, because I don't find that to be relevant to the conversation, and I'd rather keep that to myself. But this song is still being used in popular culture. One of the first examples I could think of is when Spike Lee's movie Black Klansman was coming out. It was advertised with Ball of Confusion, not only because it was a song that was relative to that time in the setting of the movie, which was in the 70s, you know, 60s, it still can speak to a lot of people to today. So as we close down, I would like to reiterate that while I do believe that the apparent state of America is in need of dire help, and that we need to really start looking to our future and really moving on from the hate and the greed and everything, the corruption, I do believe that there's hope, and I do believe that there's still a lot of love and peace to be found in this country. And I hope that someday we stop finding relevance in this song, because I think the song's message is a little too accurate and a little too real. I think we need to really work on making sure that what's in the past stays in the past. But that's all for me. I hope you enjoyed this video. Wanted to shout out anyone who watched the other Temptations video I did before, that is abnormally blowing up, and I think it's very exciting to have my first real, you know, plus 500 video. It's not much, but it means a lot. So thank you and have a great day.